Students, welcome to accountancy class. I am NARSIMULU, commerce teacher. In this video, I am going to teach you a simple cash book problem and the way how the problem is solved. Okay, now see, in the previous video I have already explained what is cash book, meaning, features and the pro forma of a cash book. So let me repeat the same information, the same which I have explained in the previous video. Here, what is cash book? Cash book is one of the subsidiary books. This cash book is maintained by all business organizations irrespective of their size and nature of business or number of business transactions. Here, cash book looks like a ledger account. So in the cash book, we record only cash transactions. We must not record credit transactions. By this, we can understand in every business organization, there are two types of transactions. One is credit transactions, another is cash transactions. Here in the cash book, we have to record only cash transactions. Cash transactions include cash receipts and cash payments. What is cash receipt? Cash receipt is the amount that we receive from outsiders. What is cash payment? Cash payment is whatever the amount that we pay to outsiders. By preparing this cash book, we come to know or we can find the cash balance at any point of time. So we come to know the cash in hand, and by preparing this simple cash book. And one more point we have to remember, that the cash book always shows debit balance. Cash book always shows the debit balance. And here you have to know that in the cash book, we are going to record all receipts on the debit side, and all cash payments can be recorded on the credit side of the cash book. So these are the important things which I have already explained. And here in this video, I am going to explain you the problem and the method, the way how to solve the given problem from this chapter, that is simple cash book. Students, here we can go to solve this problem by using 5 steps. So what are the 5 steps? See, first step is that whatever the problem that is given to you should be read carefully. So whatever the problem that is given to you, that problem should be read carefully. And this is the first step. Under the first step, what you have to do? Read the problem carefully. Try to understand what are the things that are given in the problem by reading the problem. And the second step, in the second step, what you have to do? You have to identify the cash transactions as well as credit transactions that are in the given problem. So if there are any credit transactions that are given in the problem, should be highlighted with using some underline or tick or something. Okay, so those transactions should be avoided, should not be recorded while we are preparing cash book. So which means, after identifying credit transactions as well as cash transactions, credit transactions should be omitted. We should not consider credit transactions. So it is the second point. And come to third step. Under the third step, what we have to do? We have to prepare simple cash book pro forma like this. I already prepared here. So cash book is a ledger account. It's similar to ledger account. It looks like a ledger account. So when it looks like a ledger account, it must have debit side and credit side. So in the cash book also, we can see debit side as well as credit side. So debit side, there are four columns. First column is meant for debt, second column is meant for particulars, and third column is meant for LF number, and fourth column is meant for amount. And here credit side, again right hand side of the cash book, there are four columns. First column is meant for debt, and second column is meant for particulars, and third column is meant for LF number, and fourth column is meant for amount. Like this you can go to prepare the simple cash book pro forma under the third step. And here one more point you need to remember, that you can go to write immediately opening balance. After preparing the simple cash book pro forma, you can go to write the opening balance. Where we have to write the opening balance? Opening balance can be recorded on the debit side of the cash book. Cash book always shows the debit balance. That is the reason we have to record first after preparation of simple cash book as a opening balance. Here if you observe this problem, here opening balance of the balance is given rupees 50,000. So in this problem the opening balance is rupees 50,000. Here we can go to write opening balance after preparation of the proper pro forma of a cash book. Here opening balance or balance brought down rupees 50,000. This is the important under the third step. And come to fourth step, where we have to record all cash receipts debit side, that is left hand side of the cash book, and all cash payments that can be recorded on the credit side, that is right hand side. Okay, after recording all the transactions in the cash book, now we have to find the closing balance in the cash book. How we can go to derive the closing balance? Simply from the total debit amount, or from the debit total amount you can go to direct to credit total amount, then you will find the closing balance. It is the fourth step. Okay, so like this we can go to prepare the simple cash book. So what are the steps? We can go to recapitulate. Under the first step, we can go to read the problem, it is important. And second step, you can go to identify cash transactions and credit transactions, and credit transactions should be highlighted because we must omit them. And come to third step, where we can go to prepare simple cash book pro forma with opening balance. And in the fourth step, we can go to record all cash receipts on the debit side of the cash book, and all cash payments can be recorded on the credit side of the cash book. Say here, fifth step, last and final step, that is finding the closing balance. And how we are going to find the closing balance? From the total debit amount, you can go to direct total credit amount, then the difference will come, that is the closing balance of the cash book. See, we can go to solve the given problem here by using this simple five steps. It's very easy and very simple to solve the problem. Here one problem is given. See, prepare cash book from the following information. We are asked to prepare a simple cash book by given problem. See here, 2018 January 1st, opening a balance 50,000. Now we are using the first step, means here we are trying to understand the given problem. Opening balance is rupees 50,000 on January 1st 2018. So on 2nd January, goods sold for cash rupees 80,000. It is a cash transaction. Okay, and on 3rd January, goods purchased for cash, which here we can easily understand this is the cash transaction rupees 10,000, as there is no name of a person, so that we can decide it as a cash transaction, goods purchased for cash. Here not given, but we have to understand as cash transaction. Okay, goods purchased rupees 10,000, it is a cash transaction. Come to next one, on 5th January, goods sold to Raju rupees 15,000. Here name of the person is given, so it is a credit transaction. Make it underline to highlight this transaction as a credit transaction, because we must not record this transaction in the cash book. Okay, next, come to next point, that is computer purchased. Here it is a cash transaction rupees 40,000. Furniture sold for cash rupees 30,000. Commission received in the form of cash rupees 5,000. Rent paid rupees 10,000. And salaries paid rupees 10,000. So in this problem, there is only one credit transaction. All are cash transaction, except this one, fifth on January 5th transaction. Except the 5th January transaction, we can go to record all the transactions in the cash book. It is a first step. Now second step, we highlighted second step, that is separated cash transactions and credit transactions. And come to third step, where we can go to prepare simple cash book. Here I already prepared the pro forma like this. You can go to prepare the pro forma under the third step. Now you can go to write opening a balance January 2008 first. You can go to write here to opening balance or balance carry down, sorry, brought down, opening balance. So what is the opening balance in this problem? Rupees 50,000. Here in the amount column, you can go to write rupees 50,000. And come to next transaction, that is on January 2nd, goods sold for cash. Whenever we sold the goods, we receive cash. That should be recorded in the cash book debit side. Date 2nd. January 2nd. So here to sales account, you can go to write as sales account rupees 80,000. Okay, so come to next one, goods purchased for cash rupees 10,000. So whenever we purchase the goods, the goods we pay some amount and we receive the goods. So here cash going from the business, going out of the business, so that's why we have to write it in the credit side of the cash book. So goods purchased on 3rd January 2018. Here 2018 January 3 by purchases account amount of rupees 10,000. Amount of rupees 10,000. Now next come to 5th transaction, that is goods sold to Raju. So here it is a credit transaction, we must not record it in the simple cash book or any cash book. And come to next one, that is on 8th January 2018 computer purchased. When we purchase the computer, we need to pay amount to outsiders. It is a cash transaction. So here payment should be recorded on the credit side of a cash book. See here, what we purchasing? Computer. That on January 5th by computer account amount of rupees 40,000. Here computer account rupees 40,000. Okay, now come to next, see the next transaction, that is furniture sold. Here we have some old furniture that we sold and we receiving some amount. Here it is a receipt that can be recorded on the debit side of a cash book. Date 9th January, January 9th to furniture account amount of rupees 30,000. Amount of rupees 30,000. Next, commission received. Here we received some commission in the form of cash, so that is a receipt and can be shown on the debit side of a cash book. Date 11th, here January 11th to commission received account amount of rupees 5,000. Okay, next, rent paid. It is a payment, comes credit side of the cash book. So here on 25th we paid rent payment. It is a payment that can be recorded credit side of the cash book by rent account amount of rupees 10,000. And come to next one, that is salaries paid. It is also a payment, so it comes credit side of the cash book. See, date 30 by a salaries account rupees 10,000. Okay, so here we entered all cash transactions in the cash book under the third step. Now come to fourth step, where we can go to fourth step also we completed, because we entered all cash receipts debit side and cash payments credit side. Once we can go to recapitulate how many steps so far we completed. In the first step we read the problem carefully. In the second step we separated or identified cash transactions and credit transactions. And here after identifying the credit transactions, just we highlight to omit them while recording simple cash book. And come to third step, where we prepared simple cash book pro forma with opening a balance. And fourth step, where we recorded all cash receipts debit side and cash payments credit side. Now fifth step, here under the fifth step we are going to find the closing balance. How can we find the closing balance? So the closing balance can be derived by deducting the total credit amount from the total debit amount. See here, if you see the total debit amount will be 5,000. It is a rough work here. Actually it is a rough work. How I am going to write, you see, under the rough work, debit amount 5,000 plus 1,65,000. Total debit amount is 1,65,000 rupees. Come to total credit amount, you can go to calculate 70,000. Total credit amount is 70,000. From total debit amount you can go to direct total credit amount. So then you will get the difference figure. That is 9. So 95,000. The difference figure here. Difference. This difference is the closing balance of this account. So here first you can go to write the highest amount of these two. So the highest amount of these two is here 1,65,000. Whichever is higher, that should be recorded in the total amount 1,65,000. Here credit side is the lesser amount. So with in the credit side you can go to write the difference figure on the closing date by a balance carry down rupees 95,000. Okay, so whichever is less, whichever the side shows the less amount, that side you can go to write the difference amount. This is the closing balance. This is the closing balance of the cash book. So you can go to carry forward the closing balance as the opening balance for the next month. So February 1st to opening balance 95,000. Okay, so like this you can go to find out the closing balance of a cash book. Okay, once let me repeat the entire problem. First, to solve the simple cash book problem we need to follow 5 simple steps. In the first step you need to read the problem in your mind carefully, and under the second step you can go to identify cash transactions and credit transactions, and credit transactions should be highlighted because we must omit them, we must not record them in the simple cash book. And come to next one, under the third step we can go to prepare simple cash book pro forma with opening a balance. In the fourth step we have to record all cash transactions debit side and cash, means cash receipts debit side and cash payments credit side. Okay, after that in the fifth step you need to find closing balance. How we can go to find the closing balance? From the total debit amount you can go to direct total credit amount. You will find the difference figure, that is the closing balance. The closing balance must be recorded on the credit side of the cash book on the last day of that month. Okay students, so the same figure we can go to carry forward to the next month as a opening balance. Okay, like this you can go to prepare the simple cash book by using 5 simple steps. Okay students, I hope you understood how to solve